Hi everyone and welcome back, it's Vicky here and I hope you are all well and safe. Since I am isolated at home, I play all day with my craft supplies and today I'm sharing a video with a new collection. This is the whole collection by Art by Marlene. I absolutely love her style, love the designs, the color combos, they are super happy and perfect for these days. Hopefully taking a look up close to all the products is going to be helpful for you to decide if you need something from the new collection. And I will upload another video today using products from this release, so stay tuned for that as well. You will find it linked at the end of this one. And first let's start with stamps. These are rubber stamps in lovely mandala shapes. The first one is called Boho Chic and this one is called Mandala Movement. You can stamp them on your background to create visual texture or color them with really fun colors and turn them into focal points. I know Marlene loves mandalas and in every collection she has a few of them. Now let's take a look at some of the clear stamps and I'm going to zoom in for you. Probably you will be able to see the designs better. This is the Just Beachy. You get a chubby girl on the beach, octopus, fish stars, as well as shells. And at the back of the packaging you can always see the designs better and in color. They are great both for art journal and mixed media projects as well as for a card since they are not so big. Now here is a clear stamp set that I absolutely love. You get this whimsical city along with some falling stars. There is a sun and a moon, all whimsical. I absolutely love this stamp set and I will definitely use it on a card or on an art journal page. And you can see at the back how it looks colored. Now this is called Mystical City. Now this is the mandala tapestry and you can see you get three different designs of mandalas along with some sentiments that you can mix and match. Again, use them for backgrounds or as focal points, depends how you color and how you use them on your page and products. This is a big stamp set, it's 5x7 while the two previous ones were smaller, 4.5x6. Here is another 5x7, again a big one. This is called Mariposas and you get lots of different butterflies to use. If you need different butterflies for your projects and you love using them, then this is a stamp set for you. It has different designs, bigger and smaller, and you can see at the back how they look when you color them. Now I'm going to bring in another 5x7 big stamp set, clear one again, and this is for pet lovers. You get an adorable little girl that is holding her cat, but in the set you also get loads of different dogs as well as many sentiments. So again, this is a stamp set that can be used both on art journal and mixed media as well as for a card. And I absolutely love the quirky and super unique style that Marlene has in her designs. By the way, this stamp set is called Pet Talk. So I'm going to bring another stamp set and I know this is going to be a favorite for many of you. This is called Art Supplies and you get a watercolor palette, many craft supplies like brushes and crayons and acrylic paints, even some thread, scissors, spatulas. I think this is an absolute favorite for all us crafty people. And again, this is called Art Supplies. Now here is again a 5x7 stamp set and if you like coloring people and playing with them on your pages, you get two kids who are standing, another one who is upside down. I think it's super fun. And I like how this lady here looks like a cupcake. I'm going to turn it over so you can see the images better while they are colored. And my favorite from all those four people is the upside down girl. And I will definitely use her in one of my pages. And this stamp set is called Normal is Boring. Now I'm going to bring a stamp set that I know is selling out the minute it hits the shelves. This is called Exclusive Textures and it is the number one stamp set that you want for all your backgrounds. You get so many different doodles that you can use again and again on pretty much every art journal page. Crosses, X's, lines, polka dots, little flowers, leaves. So many different options here. I know I will take them all out of the packaging and place them inside a little tin so that I can keep it on my table when I'm doing my art journal pages. And now let's take a look at the stencils. These are really big. They are about 7x7 in inches and it is really difficult to show them to you in the packaging. So I'm going to turn them over so you can see the design better at the back of the packaging where it is sprayed and has an example. But here is one outside of the packaging so you can see the size and you can see how intricate the design is. Now, I don't see a name on the packaging for the stencils, but they do have a code, so this is the stencil number one. And again, you will find everything linked below. This is stencil number two, and it is a part of a flower or a part of a mandala. Look how gorgeous it is when it is inked up. And you can use these on your gel plates as well. Here's another one that has different areas that you can use separately or as it is. It has some designs that work great for borders. And that was stencil 3. Now let's move on to stencil number 4. This has a leaf design. The next one is stencil number 5, and it has a big flower, again about 7 by 7 in inches, all of them. This is number 6, and it is full of little bubbles and dots. Love bubbles on my art journals. That's stencil number 7. It gives you different parts of a butterfly, like the wings and the main body, that you can put together on your own. And finally, here is a big mandala, which is stencil number 8. Now I'm going to put aside all the stencils and I will bring in the dies from this collection. Use them to die cut elements and stick them on your pages as focal points or different elements on your layout, or you can cut out stencils and use them with your acrylics over your layouts. Now I love this one, which is probably my favorite since it creates borders. This gives you a very intricate design of flowers, and you can see that at the back. And finally, this one can be used as a flower or even as a tag to write something inside. Now there is one more big die that I'm going to show you at the end of this video in another section. So for now, let's move on to some rice papers and some pads with collage paper. So she has come up with two collage papers. These are all full of her art. I usually don't work with those pages as they are. I like to cut out things from here and there and mix and match them on my pages. Now you get two pages for each design, and there are 10 different designs on every pad, so total of 20 pages. Of course, this is very lightweight paper since it is collage paper, and when you stick it on top of your art journal, it's going to blend in nicely and it's going to be completely flat. So use these pages to cut out flowers, leaves, to create hills for your art journals, to create borders if you like, lots of ways to use them. Now I'm going to show you the rice papers. These are sold separately. They don't come up on a pack like I have them here. And there are some black and white ones as well as some colorful ones. So again, this is rice paper, great quality. And that's the dream catcher in black and white. Houses in black and white again, so you can color them. Faces that you can cut out and use on your pages. Colorful ladies, use them separately or as they are. A little mermaid and lots of flowers. Now I'm going to bring in the sticker book. This is full of quotes that you can use on your projects. There are 7 different pages, and you get each and every one of those pages in 3 different colors, so the same sentiment can be in white, in craft, and in black. These stickers are made out of thin paper, so it sticks nicely on top of your projects, and it's not glossy at all at the top, which means that you will be able to easily write on top of them or color them in with your mediums. You will find lots of funny quotes in here, as well as a few naughty ones, and I'm going to read a few of them, such as, "My favorite color is rainbow," "Big, better, best," "Reach for the stars," "If not us, who?" "Avoid stress, stay home and craft," and many, many more. Now, if you follow me for a while, you already know that I love die cuts, and she has come up with 2 more die cut pads for this collection. These are die cut number 5 and 6 in her collection, and you get lots and lots of her designs. This is all Marlene's art. You can pop them out and use them on your pages. On the other video that I'm posting today, you will see how I'm working with them and how I put together little scenes just by using these cutouts. In these pads you will find faces, houses, flowers, butterflies, craft supplies, nautical themed ones, there are flamingos, animals, really the list is endless. And finally you get 2 pages for each design, so you can actually use the ones that you love and stop hoarding them. Now, in this collection, she has come up with different art journal books. So the first one is this one, which is her classic one with the rings. There is a little pocket at the front where you can add your die cuts. I have some extra from here that I popped up earlier, and I can always put them there so that they don't get lost. The paper is watercolor paper, thick watercolor paper of great quality. There are 30 pages in this art journal, 300 GSM or 140 in pounds. There is an elastic on the outside to keep everything together. It is the exact same great quality as her previous art journals, but it has a different art at the front. And that was 4x6. Now let's move on to this one. This is a really fun one. It is an accordion book, and I'm going to open it up for you. It is 1 meter long, it has great quality paper, that's 220 GSM. It's smooth watercolor paper, and you can use your watercolors on top of it or any other acrylic paint, just add color all over it. Then play with your stencils, add some doodling, start sticking down die cuts. And remember, this can be a continuous page or it can be different ones on every one of all those accordion folds. And here's another way to create an art journal. This is a kit that helps you create your own tag journal. I'm going to open it up for you so you can see what's included. And I do have a complete video on how I put these tag journals together. And I share there 4 different layouts. This video is going to be linked at the end of this one. So you get this thin washi tape in 2 different sizes. You get elastic to put your tag journal together. You get a little charm that you can embellish your finished art journal if you like. There is also a die here. You can cut out a piece to use it as a stencil or use the cutout piece to add a texture and embellish your tag book. And of course you get your tags. There are 21 different tags here. They have 3 different tabs, all of them. You can put together a journal as big as you want, add as many of these pages as you like, and this is Chipboard. And since I do have a project video that I share using this product, let's move on to the next one. And finally, this is another die cutting set. This one gives you lots of dies to cut out and create your own art journal book. This is going to be a mini art journal. You will be able to cut out pages for your book as well as the outside. Now the outside is going to give you both the front and the back as well as a little flap. The dies create the hole so you can put through the elastic to keep your little signatures together. It is really easy to play with and create your own, but I do promise I will make a video on creating one of those mini art journal books. It's really fun to play with and they are really easy to create. Plus, you can use any type of pages that you like. It could be a watercolor paper, it could be pages from a book, from your pattern papers, anything goes. And finally, I'm going to bring in the last product from this release. This is a pencil case. It is absolutely huge. This is 14 inches long by 6 inches, which means that it keeps lots of things inside, including your brushes, your long brushes if you want to, your markers, and of course, it can even keep a big ruler. Plus, it is decorated on the outside with Marlene's art, which makes me happy just to look at it. And that's where I'm keeping my acrylic markers from now on. So that was the whole release by Art by Marlene. Make sure to click on this video where I'm sharing how you can put together a tag journal, and I'm also sharing 4 different mini layouts on these tags. I hope that you had fun today, that you got inspired. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you all next time.